Hey everyone, it's your girl Layla. Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to Vlogmas. So, welcome to Vlogmas day 11. Now, not already subscribed, please go ahead, click the subscribe button below. I'm uploading every day till the 25th, and obviously I would love your support and your encouragement when it comes to this, because it's very hard to upload every day. I'm not even gonna joke with that. It is really hard. So in today's video, I am gonna be talking about, this is gonna be a little bit of a story time. This is going to be talking about the time that I got a bunch of money stolen off of my credit card. The person that stole my credit card information actually booked a bunch of flights, and as of this year, I was still dealing with this issue. This happened a couple years back, but one of the flight companies just wouldn't leave me alone. They would call me every single day because they had, of course, they had my address, my name, and my phone number, and this person just basically used my credit card information and used their email address, because the person on the phone at the flight company had always stated that, you know, we emailed you a bunch of times, you never reply, so that's why we're calling you. So of course this person used their own personal email address, but all of the rest of the information was mine. And this kind of does freak me out a little bit, because it's definitely identity theft, obviously, but it freaks me out in a sense that somebody is using my information, my name, my alias basically, and if they're committing any crimes, I'm kind of scared of that, you know. Andy has already, you know, kind of reassured me, saying that, of course, you know, if they commit a crime in the States, you live in Canada, like, you know, you have alibis, you know, you have witnesses, you know, you go to work every day, people see you every day, so it's not a big deal. It'll get thrown out or whatever, but it's still, it kind of freaks me out that this person had access to all of my information. So this person made a whole purchase of $1,874.72 using my credit card information. So at that point in time, the only two places that I had used my credit card in the time span of that month was on Kylie Cosmetics. I used it twice there because she had her holiday collection release and then she had a Black Friday sale. And of course, I was completely obsessed with Kylie Cosmetics, so especially 2 years ago. So yeah, that's the only place I have purchased anything, and my gas station that's literally like 5 minutes away from my house. That's the only two spots that I used my card. I would always use my card at the pump. I don't currently do that anymore. I used to do that all the time, and I've stopped ever since this has happened, because I feel like maybe somebody had put a skimmer into the machine, into the gas pump, and that's how my information got stolen. So basically what happened is they booked a bunch of these flights. This is like kind of a warning to you guys, because I know that everybody's out these days, everybody's out shopping, everybody's out Christmas shopping, getting gas and all that stuff, and it's just one of those things that you really, really need to be careful about, especially if you're going to a gas pump and pumping your gas outside, paying at the pump. That's something to really watch for, because if you think about it, that's a really easy way to steal people's credit card information. If somebody is pumping gas or pretending to pump gas, or maybe they are pumping gas into their own car and then they could just put a skimmer into the machine, nobody would ever know because the gas pumps are outside. Of course there's cameras and stuff, but during a really busy time when a lot of people are getting gas, and something that you can do in maybe less than 10 seconds, it's something that you really need to watch out for. I really honestly don't know what a credit card skimmer looks like, and it's not like it's something that I was very fully aware of at the time to look for, so I didn't even really think twice about that. I always got gas and paid at the pump, always. So that has never happened to me other than that time. So basically I logged into my banking app and I wanted to know how much damage I had spent on the Kylie, the two holiday collections, or like the holiday collection and the Black Friday sale. I wanted to just check on how much I spent, because her site is in US dollars, I live in Canada, so there is an exchange rate, and I don't always know, like I don't always check before I buy something on, you know, how small her dollar is compared to the States, so I kind of look for it after. So I logged into my banking app and I saw all of these charges for like Flight Hub and Skyscanner is the other one, I think it was, like a bunch of them. I will insert screenshots in this video, or the one screenshot that I have. It was still in my authorized transactions, so it literally happened the day before I logged in, or the night before I logged in. And I called the bank right away, explained everything. I was like, these are not my charges. And of course they took it off right away because it was still under my authorized transactions. So they were like, if the payments had gone through, if I waited another business day or two and they went through, it would have been a little bit more complicated. I would have had to wait a little bit longer, like maybe a couple days or like a week, so that they could do an investigation on what happened and everything like that. But since it was still under my authorized transactions, the bank just like took it off. So after that, I thought everything was fine and dandy and everything was back to normal. And you know, of course they gave me a new credit card and they definitely have locked my credit card a few times, let's say, since this has happened. So after I purchased my phone on Samsung Canada, they actually locked my card. I went to Walmart and I couldn't buy anything. It was like, I was like, really, what is going on? So they've definitely added a feature on my card where if I make a weird transaction, they lock my card and I have to call them, which is really annoying, but it's cool at the same time because of course what happened to me. So when I called them, they were like, can you please tell me the places that you shopped at recently? Are the two Kylie Cosmetics transactions yours? And I was like, yes, they were mine. And the other place was this gas station. So they were like, okay, you know, we'll just take the charges off your card, blah, blah, blah. I thought everything was fine. You know, I went like maybe 3 days before I got a call from one of the flight companies. I think it was maybe Flight Hub. One of the flight companies that they had bought a flight from, and I think it was the one to Montego Bay. Let's see if it actually says on my statement thing. I'm pretty sure it was the Skypicker flight, and they had booked a flight. They book a few flights, right? So they booked one to St. Louis, and they had booked one to Montego Bay, and I forget what the other one was. Maybe back to Canada. This company calls me on the phone and I don't answer. I don't really answer strange numbers. I still don't answer strange numbers. And if this place has been calling me, because they were calling me last year, like I remember them still leaving messages. Right now, currently, I have switched phone companies. I still have the same number, but I switched phone companies and I haven't activated my voicemail. So I don't really check. I don't know if they're still calling me, but they were still calling me last year. And it was like a whole year afterwards. So this company called me and then they were like, our flights are non-refundable. I guess they knew what happened but didn't really know what happened. They were like, you have called your bank to cancel your credit card transaction and it declined, and our flights are non-refundable, you're in a lot of trouble, blah 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 blah. And I was really confused. I was like, okay, like I thought the bank had fixed this for me. I thought they handled it. So I went back to the bank later on that day and I was like, hey, I got a phone call. I had to explain to her everything that happened because she was a teller and I had called the bank to take this transaction off my card altogether. So when I went to the bank, I had to explain my whole situation again. And then I had told her, like, I thought it was already dealt with. I'm getting these calls. And she was just like, you just have to ignore the calls. They're not gonna do anything to you. This wasn't even your transaction, blah blah blah. So I ignored it and they kept calling me and calling me and calling me and calling me and calling me. They were leaving voicemails. They were saying, you know, we have emailed you a bunch of times, you have to reply. Of course they knew my full name because this person had booked their flight under my name. So they knew my name and they knew my last name, they knew my phone number, everything like that. I don't know if the person used my address or if they used their own address, which would be really stupid if they use their own address because then it would be very easy to get caught. I didn't receive any mail to my mailbox saying that this company was trying to reach me or that I was going to collections or anything like that. They were still consistently leaving messages on my voicemail saying that this was not allowed on their terms that were on their website. You're not allowed to cancel your payments. You're not allowed to cancel your flights. It's a discount flight company, so they, you know, they take losses very seriously and etc. And I need to either reply to their message, call them back, or reply to their email. So one day I was just like, screw it, I'm going to call them back and explain my whole situation. So I called them. They were a New York number I called them and it was like past office hours because I am on the West Coast and they are on the East Coast, and the East Coast is like 3 hours ahead of me or 2 hours ahead of me or something like that. So I'd called them outside of business hours. They didn't answer their phone. And then I just basically just gave up from that point. I was like, I'm not calling you. I'm not answering weird numbers. I'm not answering your freaking voicemails. And yeah, that's it. That's the whole situation that happened. They were basically like harassing me for a whole year after this happened. And like I said, now I don't even check my voicemails. I don't check my missed calls. So they could be still calling me. I don't know. But that was just a really annoying situation. And it was definitely something that can happen to anyone. Like, anyone can get their credit card information stolen. That's really sad. And I'm glad I have a great credit card company where, you know, they can just take the transaction off right away if somebody has my credit card information. If I hadn't gone onto that app to check how much I owed and just didn't bother doing it for a while, then my transaction would have went through and it would have taken way longer to fix. So make sure you are really consistently being careful when you're out there Christmas shopping, when you're out there Boxing Day shopping, when you're out there, well, it's already past Black Friday, but like, you know, after Christmas sales and stuff like that. I don't know if you guys have Boxing Day in the United States, but we do here in Canada. It's like, it's called Boxing Week and everything goes on sale. So during that time, a lot of the malls are super crowded as well. So make sure you are just being very careful. That is one of the craziest things that happened, that I can't believe somebody tried to steal almost $2,000 from me. So basically, you guys, I was reminded of this whole experience that happened to me 2 years ago because somebody had stolen my Optimum points on Black Friday and used $20 worth. So I only had $20 worth because I was using them most recently on like Smashbox stuff and the Pure / Barbie collaboration that they have out right now. Basically, somebody had stolen my Optimum card's barcode and used it in Quebec, and I live in Alberta. Optimum points are just so difficult. Like, they had to launch like a case to investigate what happened. They had, like, it took 2 weeks for them to give me my points back, and I missed all of the Black Friday deals. I missed all of the Cyber Monday deals. It really sucks. That is pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you guys tomorrow in the next episode of Vlogmas. Bye, everyone.